Okay, right, we'll Hobbit with Rob, we'll go for the special rules. What have we got for the battle? Who we got?
Your general is Azog, and I haven't got Azog, so you've got Goth Mog filling in for him. Azog's special rules are General of the North, so his stand fast is 12 inches. Iron Master special rule means basically when he rolls the wound, he never needs to roll more than a 3 plus to score a wound, regardless of their defence.
Cool.
He's also been given heavy armour, so he's actually defence 7.
Right.
Okay. You also have...
And he's mounted, is he?
No, on foot.
On foot, okay.
And because I've picked the army from Azog's Legion, he also has Master of Battle special rule, which means... I'll go to here... Master of Battles. If a model with this special rule is within 6 inches of an enemy hero calling a heroic action, they can immediately call a heroic action of the same type without expending a point of might.
All right, what's the range, sorry?
6.
Yeah.
So it's quite good.
Yeah.
Your next captains are Gundabad Orcs captains, armed with swords and heavy armour, and one has a shield. Their special rule is they get to reroll ones versus when they attempt to wound elves or dwarves. So you don't need to faint.
Oh, okay.
Right, your regular troops are Gundabad Orc Warriors. They're either armed with swords and shields.
Hang on, where is it? Oh, sorry.
They're either armed with swords and shields or spear. And they also have the ancient enemy special rule, so they get to reroll ones when they wound elves or dwarves. Your two monsters is a Gundabad Troll, armed with a mace. He's got the ancient enemy special rule as well, so he rerolls ones. When using the crushing club to wound, it doesn't cause one wound, but D3 wounds. And any surviving model is knocked to ground on 3+.
Okay.
And he causes terror as
so
well.
Just for working characters, because yeah. There won't be any difference. Most things we got one wound, haven't they?
Yeah. So you wound it, then you roll to see how many wounds it causes.
Well, I say most things are dead on one wound, anyway, aren't
yeah.
they?
Yeah. That is being represented by the Mordor Troll.
Let's put something else.
Yep, yep.
The Cave Troll is the Troll Brute.
I'll just
mix. Okay.
Terror and Fearless, and he also has Crushing Blow. Each time a Troll Brute moves into base contact with another model, it must inflict a single Strength 10 hit upon it.
Wow.
And then if it stops, it's in combat. But that's your models as well.
Oh, right.
Army. And that's your army. Okay?
Cool.
My army. Commander is Thranduil, King of the Woodland Realm. He's on an elf. So
oh,
when
excellent.
So when he charges, he's strength 5.
Right.
And he's represented by the Red Mirkwood elf captain. His special rule is he's expert rider and woodland creature. When Thranduil, King of the Woodland Realm, receives +1 attack when he's on foot, Thranduil, King of the Woodland Realm, if he's engaged with, he receives an additional attack for each model he's engaged with after the first. This bonus is determined at the start of each fight and lasts until the strike start fight as well. So if you have him five guys on him, he gets 5 extra attacks.
4 extra attacks, I guess.
Then you have Legolas, woodland
I've
creature.
I've heard that chap before, yes.
Deadly shot, he can either fire 3 times or once and he'll auto hit, even if he's in combat.
Into a combat,
yeah.
Yeah.
He's also armed with Orc Rest, so basically when he rolls to wound orcs, Uruk-hai or goblins, it causes not one wound but D3 wounds. The other person I got is a Mirkwood captain. He is armed with an elven blade, which can either be used as a spear or an elven blade. And then my regular troops then. Any experts watching, I apologise, I'm still quite new to this, relatively. So, Mirkwood elves, these are...
Beautiful book again, isn't it?
Yeah. Heavy armour and elven blades, and those ones will be armed with a shield as well. And the other ones are armed with glaives, so again, spear or the elven blade.
We talked about glaives last week, didn't we?
And then I've also got Mirkwood Rangers. They are armed with elven cloak, elf bow, and daggers. Also, Mirkwood Rangers receive an additional attack for each enemy model they're engaged in combat with after the first. To a maximum of 3, so it's kind
wow.
of like Thranduil.
Yeah, they're actually outnumbered as well.
Yep, and then also Mirkwood Cavalry.
That's a big bonus, actually, isn't it?
Yeah, Mirkwood Cavalry.
Do you think they got the higher fight value as well? You check four dice, you get a good six. You can't be beaten, can you, unless it's something tough?
Strength three, though. They're a special rule.
Yeah, if you've never been hit, doesn't really matter what strength is it?
Welsh mounted Mirkwood Cavalry models count as being in range of a banner if they're within 6 inches of Thranduil, King of the Woodland Realm.
Okay.
So that's where they're in his warband.
And you got Thranduil?
Yes. And right. That's my army. I outnumber you by one model.
Well, you're themed elves, all this cool stuff, and you outnumber me, yeah?
Yep.
Because
you've got two monsters. And you have no shooting and no cavalry.
Yeah, waste time. Alright, so you've rolled up for a scenario. Thought it's different to last time. So number four came up. Lords of Battle. Both armies have been locked in a savage campaign for many long weeks and morale is low. Only the leadership of their respective captains has kept the armies in the field. Now is the time for the heroes to show their quality. So we've chosen our armies already. Starting positions, this is pretty much the same as usual, yeah. 4 to 6, you can deploy anywhere. Now the key is always, so this is the sort of map we're going to do. All right, we can do that easy enough. Right, the main thing is, once the one force has been broken, the game might suddenly end. At the end of each turn, after this condition has been met, roll a d6. On a 1, 2, the game ends. Otherwise, another turn, so this can go on for a while then. Mm-hmm. Most victory points wins. Every time an enemy model suffers a wound, or expends a fate point, you score 1 victory point. A model that fails a fate roll, therefore, award 2 victory points. 1 for the wound, 1 for the fate points. You've got to keep a score then, yeah?
Yeah.
And that's all figures, not just heroes.
Yeah, all figures.
And you score 1 victory point if the enemy force is broken at the end of the game. So it's pretty much a destroy the enemy game. Alright, special rule, contest of champions. Each time your force kills an enemy hero in a fight, one of your heroes in the same fight regains a single might point lost during the battle. Alright, so you get a bit of a boost for killing someone.
Mm-hmm.
And there's Radagast for some reason, what he's doing there.
Picture, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so we'll get everything set up, and then we'll see how it goes.
Yep.
Right, we're just starting the setup. There's the table. Far too many trees for my liking, blinking elves running around. I guess it won't take up much space. So I put my first. Oh, the warbands. We talked about the warbands, so anyway, do it again. Azog, worst warband, 5 with spear, 5 with sword and shield, and they get. No monster with that one. Warband 2, pretty much the same thing, 5 spears, 4 swords, but they get the Gundabad Troll, and the third one, 5 spears, 4 swords, with the. What do you call him? Brute.
Troll brute. Just for everyone who is playing the Hobbit and is wondering, those aren't those models. They're not, because so half of them haven't been released yet, and
they're not released yet. Well, that's a bit difficult, isn't it?
Yeah. There are conversions available.
There's always conversions available.
Some of them look very good, actually.
There we are. So we can't even win this one. We're gonna get stuck in. We've got monsters and stuff, and he's got all the shooting and all the mobility. It's got to be a punch-up somewhere. Right, I've got to remember with the monsters, brutal power attacks, you can rend, so you compare the monster's strength against the strength of the nominated model instead of its defence. Does that make much difference?
Well, say like a dwarf is defence 9. Well, my defence would be about 6, and my strength would be 3.
Oh, okay. Well, you can probably go splat many. Hurl is the fun one. Choose a direction, roll d6, and add the difference between the two model strength values as the hurl distance. Chuck it down number of inches. I think just about everything in the way gets whacked, doesn't it? Gets just knocked over.
Down.
Strength 3 hit. Additional strength 6 on the one that's been thrown.
And every model you pass through.
Yeah, that's what you want
I've
to get going.
I've seen
them
survive.
Yeah, well, you can always throw one, can't you? And then the last one is barge. All enemy models involved in a fight, even supporting spears, must back away a full 3 inches instead of the usual 1 inch. So that's why we're trying to make a gap
then
for the enemy lines.
Then you can charge again.
Oh, I see. So you knock him back and then do a follow-up charge.
But the thing to remember, you can't use your brutal power attacks on the second attack.
Right, you just get a normal
so
swing.
It's almost like a hero combat, but you don't have to kill everyone. But in fact, you don't kill anyone. They move out of the way.
Right.
Okay, so your second warband.
Okay, we'll get the rest set up. Deployment's completed. Rob had to stay pretty near the front. I thought you'd spread out a bit more, Rob, with your elves. I know you don't like to fight, you all like shooting. The cavalry go 10, not 12. Three hiding in that wood. Well, they got elven cloaks. Is that everyone got elven cloaks in? Just those three?
Just three.
So if they're outside six and they're hiding, I can't see them at all. And so I've got to get hold of them, because they've got no magic, no standards. Well, neither's got any magic today, have we? You got a couple of standards. But one thing I...
He counts as a standard.
Shall I show my slight edge now? We've got Smaug. That's the... I got Smaug. Raw.
It's about...
Hey?
It's...
You don't get out of Games Workshop figures, do you? Hey?
It's probably about £280 cheaper than the actual Smaug model.
He just needs a base, that's all. I need to find the base size and we're off, mate. We're in. I could matte varnish you to get rid of the shine a little bit. Although, shiny dragon, why not? Right, we're off. Just shuffle back, but not all of them. Just in half points. Split them up. Well, he's going to go ramming in, I suppose. And those cavalry gone hiding behind the trees. I think they're going to charge me at some point. There's not much I can do about it. And they're hiding over there. That's going to be careful of the trolls. Mind you, I'm going to need spells. You can't transfix or anything, so my troll can't be thrown into my own orcs, can it?
Nope.
So that's one thing that makes it a bit easier. All right, we're probably going to go flying up there. We've all just pushed up as near as we can get. How many shooting again?
Eight and Legolas. So Legolas is shooting with three.
He's on the white dice, is he?
Yes.
Like, just always hits, and if he should not hit. Who you all throw? You all shoot at the troll?
These ones are, yes.
All of them? Yeah. Wow. All right. What do you need?
Threes.
All right.
So two miss. And then I need sixes, then fours.
Is Legolas the same, is he?
Yes. So one,
oh, I see.
Two.
Went for the triple shot. Okay.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Three. And then I need fours on these to cause wounds.
Yeah. None. Yes.
Nope, none.
Kissed you.
These three are going to shoot at the brute. All hit.
Yeah, I'll give you that. Go on.
And then use defense five, so I need sixes. Two.
Two
wounds.
So
if you mark it on your piece of paper I gave you for the brute. No, up there.
There we go, sorry. Two wounds, yeah?
Yeah, but I don't know how many. He might have. I think he has four.
I'll put a mark with how many left. Four. Oh, I'll find that out and put it on there now, okay? Okay. Well, it's 12. Well,
I suppose I didn't move, did I? So.
Yeah. Alright, so there's two wounds left on him. Roll off. So if I go first, I can charge it. Elves, come on, I need this.
Five.
Yeah, shoot.
Three.
Damn, blast. He's going to run away now, aren't you?
Any heroic moves?
Oh, hang on. He's got one as well, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
And what's that going to be? Everyone within six? Does that include the troll?
That includes the troll, but he has room. That troll needs to be end his move within six. And he has to move first. If you could.
Oh, and I blocked him in. Is that the problem?
Mm-hmm.
See? Those are kind of fiddly skirmish game errors which do my head in. So he can't do a heroic move because you've got that guy in front of him.
If he's not going to move, he can goad them to move, but they have to finish within 6 inches of him. So, basically...
Well, can I move one guy and then move him?
No, if you call a heroic move, he has to move first, then...
But he can't move anywhere?
No. But he can tell them to move, but they have to stay within 6 inches of him.
Yeah, well, they're not going to reach then, are they?
Nope. Then they'll be able to reach these guys, but that's it.
Hang on, has the other guy got a heroic move? Where's the other one?
That one, there. But he can't.
Cause he's stuck at the back.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, I can't remember. See, all mistakes like that.
This is why I learned.
This game's all about little mistakes like that, isn't it?
You learn from mistakes.
Experience is making the same mistakes many different ways, Rob.
And stupidity is doing the same thing over and over
again. Expecting a different result. Yeah. All right, we're all going to have to go first, aren't we?
Yep.
You've run out. We're on our way, like pointy ears elves always do.
Whites need fours.
We've pushed up. So you're shooting at him again, but you might hit the elves, the orcs in front of him. Whites
need
fours, yeah.
These ones need threes. So all hits. Right.
Great.
4, 5, 6, they go through. The other ones hit the orcs.
1, 2, 3 hit orcs.
So two go through,
yeah.
Them later, and sixes to kill them.
To kill orcs, yeah?
Yeah. Oh,
kill
also,
we were meant, more
to,
elf rules,
we were meant
yeah.
to record unsaved wounds, aren't we?
Oh, yeah.
So it caused three.
Two. Well, three now, yeah.
Three.
great. This is making a really good video, is this, Rob? It's Rob learning how to write.
Okay, and then they're on the brute.
Two on the brute. What do you need? Sixes again?
Yep.
No. Oh, he survives another turn. Saved by those little orcs. We're trying to close in. I've got to get the jump this time. And this time I have left a little path for my commander.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
To run through there and him to run through there. I need to get the jump. I need to go first.
I think I'm going to have a crack on this troll again.
Yeah, that's what he's there for.
One, two, three, four, five, six. And then Legolas.
I thought we just did Legolas over this way.
No. One, two, and these three.
Ah, those two. That's really why Legolas is worse to hit.
Needed fours.
It's a shocker.
Three.
Absolute shocker.
Needed
sixes. That's what we like to see. More of them. More shockers.
No.
Oh, there's a few arrows sticking out of his armour.
And then priority.
This is important now. Go on. What are you going to do? Go on. Go on.
Two.
We can beat that. We can beat that. Four. Yes. Are you doing any heroic charges or moves? Or are you just going to die where you stand? Squealing all the way back to wherever elves come from.
Six.
So tall and players do it, so they work it all out.
Thing is, though, and he's
out
of
six. To work it out now, isn't it?
Yeah. But he's out to 6 inches, so he can't contest with his Master of Battles rule.
Oh, I see. If I'd have got him within 6 of Legolas. It's why you've got to play the same army again and again, isn't it? And if Legolas did a heroic move, I could have done a heroic move. We'd have rolled off to see who was first or something.
And you would have been a 3 point of might for you as well.
Yeah, well, it wouldn't have cost a point of might.
Right, Legolas, yeah, he's going to use up a point of might.
So what if I do it as well? We roll off, isn't it?
We roll off and see who goes first.
So how much might has Legolas got?
Three. Down to two.
And who's that? That's my first guy, Azog, yeah?
Yeah.
Azog's got might. No, hang on. Oh yeah, three. I've got three as well.
And I think I'll do a heroic move with Thranduil as well. Yeah.
Right, okay.
Because he can move... If
so winning the roll-offs really helped me not at all.
He can remove through the woodland here because his base will fit through. And obviously he's got a woodland creature as well. There.
Yeah, okay. So we're going to roll off on the...
Yeah.
So I get to go first. It makes no difference, really. I said Azog if I got him in closer. All right, and do Azog against Legolas first then, yeah? Which one are you doing first?
Are you using...
Yeah, I'm using a point of might, yeah.
Okay, on who?
Azog against Legolas.
Have you colored it in?
I will color it in, okay. Well, hang on, I've got another... I've got this guy, haven't I?
Yeah. But, so Azog's one will be within 6 inches of him, so all these lot. So, but we have to see who goes first.
All right, Azog will go against Legolas then.
Oh, wait, so if you lose this roll... Both my guys go.
Oh, it's the whole side, is it?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so...
So Roland's to go first didn't really help me much, did it?
Okay, so because you're phasing player, 1, 2, 3, it's you, 4, 5, 6, it's me. It's me.
Great.
So these 6 inches here is all this group.
Mm-hmm.
An important thing to remember is if they don't move now, they don't move at all.
Oh, that's right, because they're all part of the heroic activation, aren't they?
All right, so... I think... Legolas is going to do... What's the fight value of your Gundabad Troll?
7.
Right. Legolas is going to take a courage check.
What's Legolas's combat?
Oh, it's...
Less than 7.
5.
Yeah.
So I'm charging in.
You're charging?
Yeah,
wow.
Courage test first.
Passes. Can't wait to get there.
Okay. This guy's gonna go and attack the troll.
Alright, well, we'll come back after so we get in here. Yeah?
He's in.
Oh, wish I put kept the camera on. You rolled a 3, then 2. That's with 2 dice.
Okay. Alright, so the rest of the movement, so they have to finish within
so
6.
So to charge him, they got to pass a courage test.
Yeah,
so no one else is charging
failed,
him, is that right?
This one has failed.
Alright, and no one else is charging, the rest
not,
is moving up
yet.
Or charging orcs or whatever.
So he is going to engage. Those two.
Those two, well, he's brave. Oh, yeah, of course he gets the bonus for being outnumbered, doesn't he?
No, he doesn't.
Who gets the bonus for being outnumbered, then? Oh,
those
just the guys in the wood?
Thranduil.
Oh, it's not everyone. Oh, okay, that's not so bad. I was going to say that's my best chance in this game is mob on, isn't it?
Okay, so...
All right, okay, we'll come back to it when he moves.
He is going to go engage these two.
Yeah, all right.
Captain is going to move here.
Yeah, usual brave at the back.
Good.
Ooh, something to focus on here. What happened there? Alright, so this... So you've done that quite cleverly now, because he... If he touches any of my guys, he does a strength 10 hit. and he can't get out because you've tied all my orcs in. I really need to go first this turn, didn't I? Okay, and I can't help the troll out. Legolas has got a one-on-one with him because all the support's blocked off. So I can get a support with a spear, and apart from that, it's going to try and take out as many elves as I can. Alright, okay, I'll have a go at that. Elves in the end are going to shoot, not charge, because they're outside there, follow me or whatever, so they can charge. Hitting on threes, are you?
Fives. I've hit.
Yeah, 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 yes, I'm saying. You've hit on threes, yeah.
Defense five, so fives to kill.
Nope. Alright.
Combat then. Your phasing player, so.
Oh, I want to see the troll squishes Legolas.
Do I do a heroic combat somewhere? I'm going to do a heroic strike with Legolas to make it clear now.
What does that mean then?
I roll a d6 and that increases my fight value by d6.
Ooh. So you're 5 at the moment and I'm 7.
Yeah, so as long as I get a 2.
That'll be even. You want to get 3, don't you?
Yeah, but I can always boost it with might.
Yeah, all right. Okay. Do you want to do that now?
Well, it's your whichever combat.
Yeah, I want to do that first.
Okay, right.
Will, you know.
Legolas is going to go up to...
9.
9. So you fight 9.
The blank look on your face. The 5 plus 4 is my calculator.
Legolas is fighting with those two. My elven blade is going to go two-handed. And then two spear supports.
Yeah.
Let's check Legolas has 2 attacks. Yes, he does.
Well, how many attacks? I put those markers on for will and everything. I get 3 attacks.
Yep.
All right.
So if I roll a 6, you have a supporting spear as well.
Oh yeah.
So if I roll a 6, I win.
But if it's Legolas, which colour's Legolas?
White. Oh. But that is actually a 4, because 2-handed.
Oh, only a 4 to beat then.
At the moment.
Oh, blinking heck.
So.
Oh, I just take a crunch on the troll.
He has to go back, and he can just about... Because he can't go into base contact with any of mine, so he can just...
nudge back a little bit.
I think in a tournament, that would be considered trapped, maybe, but...
God, you trap a troll like that, he just pushes... All right, okay, we were told, but I'd have done him last, then.
Yeah, it's okay. So,
okay, no, it's good to point it out, I need to learn the rules,
so
yeah.
Legolas is strength 4, so 4 onto 8... is 6, so Legolas needs...
Only 6s?
Yeah, Legolas... Wow. Is a Legolas
move. Yeah, 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 no, I thought it'd be higher.
No. And then these two guys, so they'll need... So that's 3... So 6s followed by 4s. This one gets a plus 1.
The yellow gets a plus 1.
Yeah.
Oh.
So 6.
Oh, 2 6s.
So
wow.
2. So then 4s. So uh-oh. Then this one will need 3s.
Uh-oh. And he got the 3
one,
as well.
One wound.
One move. All right, it's not too bad. All right, we'll do the rest of the melees and come back.
We're dead, so you're on 4 points, but checking the break-in points, you're not on 5. Have I killed 5 or 4?
I've killed 4. You kill 4, and you put wounds up. You can see them here. I got the red dots out. I actually killed one the previous turn. No, that's it, just those.
Just 4. Okay.
Yeah, so this side's going really well. The yellow dots are dead elves. The red dots are dead orcs. It's going great, 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 great. And the cavalry with all their double attacks was a bit nasty, but we did kill one of those nasty Mirkwood blade masters or whatever it is. So we'll get all those markers off, and I think I really want to go first to stop those cavalry charging again. You ready to roll?
Yep.
Rock and roll. 6. Oh, that went up and down the hill, didn't it?
If I roll a 6, it's
you go first, yeah, but you didn't, so right.
Okay.
Once, first thing I've done is move the brute in, and he gets a strength 10 hit immediately. Oh.
And he can continue to move then. So he come into base contact. So if he... So basically...
Alright, do you remember how far he moved? He started there, okay.
So if you those were regular guys and you killed them, you could keep on ploughing until your move's end. Or
oh,
until
so
you
take all those cavalry up?
You won't kill Thranduil because he's got 3 wounds, though.
He doesn't do the D3 thing?
No.
Right, oh, I see. So I could have just gone for the other guy, hope for the lucky kill, and gone... Yeah, I got to get a pip on Thranduil. So what's only your 3 against Thranduil, yeah?
Well, do the Mirkwood Elf first, because I'll kill him. So 3.
Right.
Nope. And then Thranduil. Yep.
No,
right. I'll fate it. Nope. I'll do another point of fate. Yeah.
So I get 2 points. No. You saved the wound.
But I failed 1 fate.
So I get 1 for the fate. Right, let's check that.
I'm going to
to go around.
Right, okay.
And charge there.
Alright, so I've charged as many as I can over here.
So I'll put that there to say that he's charged.
Okay, Rob's doing his. I've got a sneaky one here because I'm thinking of the orc going in.
He
can fight Thranduil.
He's going to engage both them.
Oh, sneaky. So he can engage Thranduil, which means the troll doesn't get hit by the hero, and the troll could take out the horse guy, and the cat can take the horse guy. That's the plan anyway, because I got the jump this turn, so the horses
he's
aren't charging.
Support him.
Or the cavalry.
He's going to support him.
Yeah, the troll gets surrounded. The troll need to roll a courage test against the little pretty blonde girl in the skirt there. And he did 6 on 2 dice and rolled a double 1, so the troll is... What did you say the name of the sword was again?
Orcrist.
Oh yeah, of course it is. Yeah, Orcrist is dazzling in his eyes. And he's so scared of the little blonde girl, he's going to stay there. And, not
3
fight.
3 inches with him.
Yeah, see? Should be running away more of these little girls. Sorry, I shouldn't call them that. It's insulting to girls.
He's going to move
sexist.
To here. And I'm going to shoot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, you're not engaging the troll?
Into the troll.
Oh, sneaky, sneaky. Now you're playing like a proper elf. All this macho fighting and melee stuff.
So
he stood there. He's dazzled by the sword and all these arrows are going to come thudding into him.
Well, you're going to win the fight, you see. I'm going to at least get a wound in with these shots.
Yeah,
shot.
Go on in.
3 regular shots and Legolas on the white.
Legolas is not going to do it, is it? Automatic hits with 3 shots.
Yellows needing 4s, everything else 3s.
Yeah, only the one misses
Legolas,
of course.
So, 6s.
Oh.
2.
Oh, he's alive anyway.
Right, I'm not rolling those ones again.
What
do
you need,
4s? 1, so 1 more.
1 wound. Alright, okay. That could have been a lot worse. It's so annoying though, because if you charge Legolas, you've got to pass a test, so I guess. Well, I didn't pass. If I passed the test, I wouldn't mind if I could have just charged the normal elves. Oh, I've got a little helper's coming in. Why are you eating chocolate biscuits? I can't see one in your hand for us, me and Rob.
I'll go get one for you.
Just get one for your dad. It's
alright now, Rob needs a sugar boost to make up for the depression he's about to get when his elves all get squished.
Right then, any heroic combats?
Right, okay. Why would I do a heroic combat?
What heroic combat allows you to do is that goes first, and if you kill the members of that combat, any member of engaged in that combat, excluding spear support, gets to move and engage in another combat.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. No, we'll keep our mic for fiddling the dice.
Okay. Which fight would you like to do first?
I don't know what that's not important, is it?
He's charged. That's why I put it there.
Oh, okay, so he's charging. All right, okay. Alright, let's crack on. Over there, it's gone disastrously. We get chopped up. The troll didn't get to fight and got shot with the bows. He's taking another wound. Lost. 2 more red marks. And a bit of playback. Azog. Oh, I should be another marker in there, I think. There's the one. Azog. Azog killed a cavalry guy there. Good old Azog. And his guy next to him. Now, this is the decision. Because I got these two guys. He's the captain on the one there. I put this guy in to distract Thranduil from fighting the troll, but the problem is now, if a troll does fight me, it's an extra attack because of him, yeah? It's his special rule. Oh yeah, those two fought out. He killed once, that was a bit of a bonus. I got the captain there. I think I'm going to have to take a gamble with the troll against Thranduil. How many attacks does Thranduil have?
He'll have 4 now.
So he gets 4 chances to wound as well?
If I win.
So I made it more like you kill the troll. Are you going
to forget to re-roll with these. Banner. Never mind. My fault.
Which banner? Where?
Thranduil counts as a banner to the knights.
Ah, so we should have killed Thranduil first. All right, well, that decides it then. All right, the troll and the guy that's supporting is going to go for Thranduil.
Damn. I forgot about that.
So what do I get? My troll gets 3 attacks?
Whatever it says on the profile. Troll brute.
Oh. The brute, isn't it?
Daddy, next
3 attacks. Yeah, sorry about that, Rob.
Daddy, next time if he has Thranduil.
Well, I should have Thranduil first and he'd be dead anyway.
Daddy, next time if he has a brilliant elven hero or something, Daddy, and you have 2 trolls.
Oh, a 6. We got
try
1 6.
Try
on.
Put both trolls.
Oh, he's got a 6 as well. Can't beat Thranduil.
So Thranduil.
Well, should I get the trolls in?
What's
his
defense?
Try get both the trolls.
Are you going to go for the troll?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to get the trolls in, yeah.
No, both of them against Thranduil.
Yeah, it'd be almost impossible, I think. 6.
5s.
So what do you need?
2.
What do you need?
I need 5s.
Is that all you need?
Yeah. troll gone.
Oh, that's what I was afraid of. And that counts two wounds for you, doesn't it?
Yeah, one, two.
Yeah. That was the risk. And putting that bloke in to help him made it worse. That was a disaster. Yeah, well.
How is it
right.
a disaster?
Well, because his special skill, every extra guy who outnumbers him, he gets an extra attack. So we got four chances to kill a troll.
I don't
think
that would count with spear supports, though.
Yeah.
Because technically spear support isn't the combat.
Oh. Yeah, so but no, the idea was for him to pin Thranduil and then clobber this guy, which is what I should have done. Basically, chaff at Thranduil and... anyway, so I got my captain, yeah?
Yeah, so you're taking 10 casualties, yeah, in total?
Whatever.
No, just count them up, just
I don't
sure.
know, that's a sec, I'll have a look in a second. I'm just trying to find my captain a sec. This one, yeah?
Yeah.
Only one attack.
Attack!
No, that's a Gundabad Orc. At the top, the commander's always at the top.
Oh yeah, sorry. Two attacks.
Yeah.
Trading.
Sorry, bit of a delay there. Two attacks.
Oh yeah, we still got combat. Fighting normally.
Yeah, two attacks with the boss guy. So I can use a might. That's not going to help though, is it? What's
well.
Your fight skill?
Five. Higher than yours.
You sure?
Yeah, captain should only be four.
Yeah. Oh, that's a special character, that's what I was thinking of. Three, actually.
No, is it four?
Oh yeah, four. Yeah, alright. Last. Right. So they lost anyway.
Yeah, so
that's where I could have imagine the troll have lost the sixes. Oh no, the troll might have beaten the six, wouldn't it?
My Thranduil's fight
value. Not Thranduil, the guy next to him.
What's this troll's fight value?
It's got seven, wasn't it? Oh no, it's the thug, isn't it? It's not the good one. So four.
So I would have still beat
it. Oh, I beat it anyway. Alright.
So it's six to wound your captain.
No.
And right. then priority.
So that's a disaster. I lost one, two, three, four,
five.
Five and two wounds
and
on
the troll.
Two wounds on the troll, yeah. So yeah. 7 points this turn. And you
so
lost
like,
3 points.
Points-wise, it's 15-7.
Uh-oh.
Because 10...
Uh-oh.
13-14... You got 10? No, 9-11-12-13-14.
Right, we'll go with that while Rob gets his calculator out. Okay. Oh, captain over here. No, it's not my turn. I just did a heroic move with him to make sure we charge the cavalry rather than they charging us. Guy's within six, so Azog's in six, but unfortunately, this I couldn't get to charge him. That was outside six. Now Rob's doing his stuff. God, man. I'm not sure what else I could have done different, really, because, I mean, I haven't got any shooting. I haven't got much movement. I've got to get stuck in, and just the elves are creaming us. Well, I just got to get the trolls in more, I suppose, but the one...
Elves are elite.
Yeah, but they've got more of them. They can outnumber us as well.
Charging
because the trolls. Well, the trolls are so expensive, you see, and I made a bit of a mess of that troll. I should definitely have taken Thranduil and kept him alive.
If he gets a two,
and then I can heroic move now, and he could be clonking in, couldn't he?
Then he would say, I think you should use the Witch King again sometime.
Oh, I like the Witch King. Yeah, that's a different army to this one. We try a different army. What are they called again? Dundigan.
What's that?
These orcs they've got.
Gundabad.
Gundabad. Sorry, yeah, Gundabad orcs.
Oh,
it's a
so
specific army.
Mordred.
It's not the new box. No, it's new box.
They're not Mordred.
No, I'll try Mordred again next time, I think. But anyway, we're still going to have a go now. There's a bit of thinking going on here. I've got to get that troll in. Got to rip up. The brute is the one I didn't get going, with his 10 every time you hit something. Right, well. Alright, come back in a few hours when he's done this. No sledging! Killed everyone with a troll.
You'll just clip your last guy there.
I just hurled him through all those elves. And a couple of orcs. Oh, hang on. I just zoomed in again for some reason. Hang on. There we go. That's better. Right. Why couldn't this have happened two turns ago? So basically, you do this. So you won the combat. You do the strength difference, which is four. And I rolled a four. So you went 8 inches.
This
now they all take a strength three hit now, don't they?
You auto get auto dismounts because of that. As well, because the horse bolts.
Oh, right. Oh, well, that's an interesting rule, yeah.
Okay,
isn't it they all take a strength three hit now, isn't it?
Yes.
And a strength six on a guy who's actually thrown, wasn't it?
And then an additional hit for every model he passed through. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Wow.
Okay, so...
Oh, so the guy who got thrown is in real trouble then.
Yeah, so first of
all...
Oh,
you told me hurling was good. Yeah, is that good?
So you'll need six on him...
Six. This is going to be carnage. Yes.
Head.
Six.
Five.
Yes.
Five.
The troll's going to save the game now. Six of that. I'm not making this up. There's six. No camera tricks. No. Oh, boo.
Six. No. Six. No. Five for your guy. No. And first of all, the strength six hit, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So that'll
probably
be
a four, is it?
Six on two. Was he? Five. Four, yeah. No, and then
seven.
Seven strength three hit. So needing,
seven chances to get a six.
So needing fives. Fives on him.
Alright, okay. Yeah, there's a couple of sixes in there. Well, after that dramatic start of 666, I was thinking, I like saying 666 way, though. It depends. Look at all those red markers.
So three more kills.
All those red markers are dead orcs on this turn.
Three more kills and I'm broken.
Four. So how many kills did the troll do then? Three, wasn't it? Four. I got a second, darling.
What's this for?
Superman, a Man of Steel. It was a backdrop, so you can play, you can move your guys around looking at that in the background, I think. So four more for the troll. One, two, three, four. The troll's taking the lead. Trolls kill five, orcs have killed four, and Azog has killed three. Azog let me down. Hit four dice to get a five, didn't get it.
Priority.
Oh, I'm glad I took a few with me anyway. Six. Four. I just keep running sixes now. Well, I could have done this earlier. A bit late to save the day, but we'll have another go. Probably the last turn, I think, because I'm one wound off breaking.
Yeah.
And you're three off breaking, yeah?
Three.
But this isn't automatically broken in this game, does it?
Yes, we will break. Because
But the game doesn't end, doesn't it? Isn't the case you have to roll one or two, I thought I read in the scenario details?
Yeah, the game will end. We roll one or two, but the game will continue, and then we're still broke. You still need to do your courage tests and stuff. But remember, Azog, 12 inch range, and is stand fast.
Oh, good, good. I say, because one thing with orcs, once they break, it tends to. They disappear very quickly. Anyway, let's tidy up more markers and I'm going to go.
I'm going to do a heroic move with my captain there.
Oh, he's outside the range of Azog. I can't do much about that, really. Have I got any? You killed my captain, didn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's the two red marks there. That's who my commander was. The captain. All right, go on, do that. Do your heroic move and then I'll tidy up and start the next turn. Is it going to be a quick one or is it going to be a.
So.
I was just going to pile in. Alright, well, we'll show you what's happened after everyone's moved. Shots, no shooting, no heroic combats.
Nope.
I had a good turn to go first there. Everything's piled in. I think I'm going to be broken this time. I think we could take quite a few elves with us if it goes well. And I'm phasing player this time.
I think we might both be broken.
I think we're both going to break, yeah. That's just been a slugfest in the middle, isn't it? Do the troll first. What?
Do you think if we. Players, if they go off the board, do they count as wounds as well? If they run away?
Off the table?
Yeah, I think I'd count
them. Yeah, I'd have thought it's off the table, yeah. Why would it? When they were near the edge, I was just out of curiosity, was it? Just mess up my video, okay. Well, I better the troll first, I think.
So, you know, if.
Oh, yeah, can he throw through a melee, or is that not allowed, is it?
He can get the sport there, but if he hit those guys, your guys are getting knocked.
All right, so I want to do the melees first, see what's standing, and then the troll goes last and chucks them through.
I believe so.
That's the way to do it, isn't it?
I'm going to get that on camera if I'm wrong.
Yeah, yeah, that's all right. Next tournament, I'll be passing badges out. Hey, Rob, get the rules wrong about. Anyway, so we just basically piled in. We got guys on the floor, thanks to that hurl, so we can hit them on the floor, which I always like to hit them on the floor. What did Blackadder say? Never hit a man when he's down. He might get up again. We're trying to take the cavalry. Done really well against the cavalry. Not only a few of them left. Might usually get them all. All right. Well, there's some long words in there. Back and forth with the melees there, but the trolls rolled a six. So, right, they showed you the hurl. The hurl's great. So it's basically aim for that tree, yeah? He's going to clatter through all the elves. I don't care if I hit any. Oh, my, I could hit Legolas as well, couldn't I? Because my arm is broken anyway.
Well, he'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 if you go that direction. And then he'll stop at the tree.
Well, can I just angle it a bit more and take him and Legolas as well? How's that going to work?
You can get.
Is it the whole width of his base?
Where anywhere on his base he can swim from. So you can swim.
I mean, that's like a. No, but I mean, is it the whole width of the base or just a line?
It's a line. You draw a line.
Oh, right, okay. Oh, I see. If it's the whole width of the base, you get the lot. Because I guess it's him who's throwing. It's not the troll that's being thrown, is it?
No, it's not the troll.
So from any point on my base, I could say go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 go that way. Would that be a line?
Yeah, that'd be a line. So 1, 2, 3, 4 because his base will pass through it.
Yeah, I've got to try and get Legolas as well, yeah.
So
all right, so range first of all. Horse is 6 inches, that's enough anyway.
Yep, so we land her.
Alright, so do you want to point and call?
Okay, so...
Oh, they all go down, do they?
Yeah. Awesome. Five?
Five.
No. Six? No.
That seems five. Last time. Oh!
Legolas is...
Come on, that's what I want.
A five. No. And then a strength six hit on him, so it would be a...
Three's not enough.
And then one, two, three, four, strength, so you need fives.
Yeah, you got one. Thank God for that. I didn't get anyone at all. Oh, disappointing. Especially they're broken. But there we are.
Two more.
Two now. More.
Three. You need to kill three to take me past break.
Oh, right, okay. Oh, well, I thought...
No, because you...
Yeah, yeah, no, I understand that. But I thought you needed two of mine then, do you? Or was it one enough?
Oh, no, no. You're 17. You're on 18 kill.
Oh, okay. 18 all right, fair enough.
I'm going to shield.
Yeah. Do I get two dice? You're on the floor?
Only to wound.
Wound, right. Two. Oh.
Nope. And he jumps back up.
Yeah, all right. So I got two on the going on the floor again.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to shield again.
Four to beat. Three. Reroll. Three. Reroll. Blasted rerolls, man. They killed me. That banner. Oh, I should have done a banner first. What a muppet. All right. We'll make the same mistake twice. Azog's going to take out that banner bearer.
Right.
Come on, Azog. He's my man.
Roll your three then.
See. You'll beat Azog. Fives.
I can't beat that because I minus
one. Oh, you're minus one because the banner on you.
Yeah.
Sixes. Yeah. Azog's got another one. Bloop. And his mate picks the banner up. Yeah, they changed that rule. It's a good idea, isn't it? I mean. Oh, I see. So he's still going to get your reroll. Oh, I'm dull as a brush some days, I tell you. I know most days. Ah.
Do you know what would have been clever? You could have done.
Go on, what's it clever?
Because he's got a mace. Instead of killing him, you could have knocked him to the ground, and the banner has no effect when the banner's on the ground.
Yeah. But I wanted to kill him.
You wouldn't have known.
But I wouldn't have got a kill, though, would I then?
No.
But I wanted to kill.
I wouldn't have had the reroll.
Yeah, but I killed one at least. Okay. I need one more, don't I? One more?
16, you need two more.
Hang on, it was two more before I killed him. I just killed the banner bearer.
I do.
Yeah, he is dead.
One, two,
nice sleight of hand there. You've got to watch these guys, you know.
12, 13, 14, 15, 16. No, you still got two more.
Still two more. I guess I'll always two more. Are we there yet, Dad? Right. Okay. One on him. Two. Oh. Rubbish. Okay, we'll whack him.
I just check if I can use a shielding rule with the glaive.
Can you shield when you're on the floor anyway?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. What do I read about shielding on the floor?
Can't shield on a horse.
There's some rule about being on the floor. I can't remember. No, oh, another rule interruption.
Yep, I can shield with the glaive.
On the floor. What's this for?
That one.
Oh, he's shielding as well?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. It's because it's no break mode now, is it?
No, why it is.
Everyone's just going to shield. Yeah, it's all right, whatever, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
No, it's because they're on their own.
No, it's not. It's because you broke me and I haven't broken you yet. That's exactly what you should do, isn't it? Are you going to shield there as well? Can you shield your horse?
I can't shield on a horse now.
I should think not. Oh, hang on, that's...
Captain.
Capitano, two dice captain, isn't he? Not a big captain.
Reroll.
Oh, here we go, here we go. Oh, right, okay.
So,
let's wind this up.
Fives.
Yay! Another one for the captain.
One more kill, then.
One more kill needed?
Yeah, two more.
Two more, still two more. Yeah. Oh, it's a tough ask, but it's always two more, isn't it?
So we're doing Thranduil.
Well, Thranduil, we're going to kill Thranduil now in one swipe. Four. Yeah, funny enough, I came second in that one. I hate Thranduil.
Dead.
Yeah, another one dead. Actually, you didn't kill many this turn, did you? Good job you did break when you did, because I got one against two.
Guy on the horse was faint.
You can fall off his horse.
Yeah, got him.
Reroll. That winning runs. Draws and rerolls is crucial.
Reroll.
Yeah, here it comes. Nope. Nope. All right, cool. I think that's it, isn't it?
Yeah, I just count my...
Wasn't that a thing? I have to roll to see if the game continues or something?
Yeah, we roll now. Wait a second, let me count my dead. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, because the guy's on foot there.
Still 16. 4,
5, 6, 7, 8, 4. 17, yeah, one more you'd need.
Oh, that's so close, eh?
But the game might end now.
You're all at one or two, it ends, isn't it?
I'm excited to see when it does. So we are playing Lords of Battle.
Is it?
Right. Once the force has been broken, the game might suddenly end. At the end of each turn after this condition has been met. So not yet.
Because do I have to do my runaway test?
Yes. So, but we do it after the priority roll.
All right, so now then. Roll now then.
No, because...
The turn has ended now, hasn't it?
Yes, it... Once the one force has been broken, the game might suddenly end at the end of each turn after this condition. So would that be next turn or this turn?
Ooh. I'd say no.
Go on then, roll.
Go on, you roll.
You're freezing player.
Oh, so technical. It's supposed to be random anyway. Was it one or two?
One or two it ends.
No.
We continue.
Oh, great.
The battle continues.
Oh, mind you, if I go first, you've got a lot of guys on the floor. Let's take a few L's with this. Yeah?
Yeah.
Come on then. Six.
Five. Yes. You're going first then.
All right, let's take a few L's with us, boys. Oh, now I got to do my route test first.
Yeah, so Gothmog's 12-inch.
Yeah, well, you might get them all, I think. He's getting everybody, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. Wait a second, though.
Oh,
Hurric move with... No, he's like... Yeah, Hurric move with Thranduil.
Well, I got to do my break test first, haven't I?
Not if I move first with Thranduil.
Oh. What are you going to do then? Come on, then. You're going to do something sneaky. What, are you going to try and take out Azog? Oh! I can't believe it.
And he's going to shout with me. So he's going to go
course,
there.
Yeah. What? Azog still gets his commanding presence, right, doesn't he? Or his,
He has to do his courage test first, and you don't do it when you're in combat.
What do you mean you don't do when you're in combat?
He doesn't... Basically, because he's in combat, he hasn't to do his courage test. So because he can't do his courage test...
Can't use his bubble.
And neither can your other captain.
No,
either.
That's just sneaky, sneaky, that is. Sneaky elf sneakies.
But your captain... So basically, where Thranduil was there... He can't.
But I gotta say, I could have declared a move as well.
You said you weren't challenging her. You said you weren't. I said, are you gonna challenge? And you went, no.
Oh, I see what you mean. I didn't. Okay. I misunderstood what challenge meant. But anyway, you know, that's fair enough.
Okay, so.
Boo.
Now it's your move.
Oh,
so
no. So all the orcs run away now. Oh, no, that's no chance.
So,
No, I hate this.
So, it's a courage to. Check, I think. The courage.
I've had it now.
Oh no, the courage three.
Oh, three?
Let me check with the book.
Four, it says here, mate.
No, oh, that's the captain's.
Yeah, worth a try.
The troll, so you need the courage check.
Three,
for the troll.
Three. It says three everywhere, yeah. The troll, though.
Courage
start
three.
Rattling those dice. Four, the troll is.
Okay, what do you want to do first?
Troll.
Courage four.
If he goes, I go. He's six, yeah? Six.
Yeah.
Made it. All right, well, I'll just do a couple as you can see.
In.
12, he's really furious now. 8, yeah. Yeah. Come on. Shouldn't have laughed. 6, that's alright. Oh, 6? No, it's 7, isn't it? Oh, flipping one off there. Yeah, he's alright.
Gone.
I hate these route rules. Especially if you're going to take out my leader.
That's why I did it.
Yeah, no, I can see the smile on your face. I knew it was sneaky, sneaky up you.
That's why I measured it.
Oh, great.
Five.
So now I've got nothing left now. All right, we'll just quickly wrap this up, see if I can kill some of my troll.
All right, so your regular movement now.
Yeah, whatever. Oh, I guess I should have filled the last turn. That heroic chance to kill an elf. Amazing. I won almost every melee and just could not roll above a 2 on a wound. Did nothing, nothing, nothing. Lost a couple as well. Even Azog went down, we both did a mighty... What do they call it? Mighty combat or something?
Heroic strike.
Heroic strike. I rolled lower than the elves.
So that was it.
Both got sixes, so you got duffed up. At least you didn't die. Even the troll lost. Everyone lost. We're all friend of the game. And it's a 2. So that's it. All done. I got too many pictures of people happy because they thrashed me in games. Well, yeah, that's a pretty good pick.
Well, we've
only 1 point off. We'll do the points and I'll do a wrap up. No, I can't be bothered.
No, let's do a point.
Elves won. Well, I, you know what we did? I did all yours bar one and you slaughtered me.
I'm not.
When I
broken.
Started running away, that's a problem.
No,
I couldn't get my one more hit, could I? So I've done 17, yeah.
So that's 1, 2. How many wounds on Azog? One wound on Azog, isn't it?
Yeah, plus, yeah.
So six.
He used a fate, but his fate was a success. Does that count as a point? No, it's failed fates, wasn't it?
Yeah. So it's 1, 2, 3. So he has 6. And how many dead are they?
The rest.
Let's count them up so we can guess final scoring.
Oh, God.
So 4 for the pedants. Troll.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And remember 2 for the captain as well.
6, 8, 9, 10, 14. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. And the captain's with 2, so that makes 29.
So that is...
Good grief.
35, 18.
Is that a win or a draw? What's the 35, 18? Is that,
it means...
Does that count as a win?
You just pick me.
Do I get a win? Because elves are worth 2 each, so that's 36 doubled up. Well, there we are. Like I said to Rob earlier, there's a lot more orcs than elves in the world. At least there was.
It means almost coming last in a tournament has taught me a couple of things.
Well, that's it. That's it. You've set the bar pretty low, and I've still managed to duck under it. So there you go. Oh, well, there you are.
Thanks for giving me a moral boost.
A moral boost.
I always need it.
Yeah, well, you always know where to come. When your confidence is low, just come round here and give me a spanking. Yeah.
He doesn't know any of the rules.
Yeah, on a swat up next time.
No,
the Mariah book.
You're getting a lot better on the rules.
Yeah, I did read the rule book as well. I'm getting better.
It's what happened then.
I'm not sure what else I could do, though, to be honest, because, I mean, I've got no shooting, not much movement.
I think because I got those couple of shots in. And the thing is...
Because I thought you'd have run away more and just kept shooting for a while and picked away at me. I mean, you just stand there and slug it out.
The problem is I can only go half and shoot. So...
Yeah, but if you spread them out, maybe, and shot for a turn, fall back. You know, I'm still going to catch you soon.
Yeah.
The thing is, I can get the trolls. The trolls are the key, aren't they? Once you get the troll in, you show how devastating the troll can be.
I think the thing with me, as long as I have a couple of dice to roll, as long as I tie, I'll win the fight. Every time.
Winning ties is a big help, especially when you throw in 2 or 3 dice, because if you get a 6 or a 5, you're almost bound to win, aren't you?
But the problem is I still need the 6s to wound you until I broke that line and got into your shields. I think the thing...
No, they're tough enough,
your guys, is you have no cavalry, unless you put Azog on a warg, and then there's only him. You've no shooting, so that's a problem. So you just have to base through the...
Well, the trolls are good, but the trouble is you can shoot the trolls with those elf posts, can't you?
Thing is, though, I only took one wound after shooting on him.
But then
I think I should have concentrated on that one first because he's the weaker target.
Well, the brute, yeah, I made a mistake because I should have chaffed up Thranduil because I couldn't kill him anyway. I did the right idea. Move that guy around. Thranduil's got to fight him because I was the phasing player. And then the troll could have bashed up some more props.
What I would have done, I would have chaffed Thranduil with the orc, but not with the troll. Because Thranduil's fight was higher than the troll.
Yeah, so the troll would have fought the guy next to him, because the troll engaged both.
But if he had killed them, he could have literally gone... He could have gone 6 inches, and if he had killed every one of them, he would have gone all my cavalry, and then just keep...
You've got to get the trolls in with this army, haven't you?
But the thing is...
The orcs are just troll delivery, really.
The thing is now, with, you know, putting the one guy to block, is if I called a heroic combat, and I killed him... Thranduil can still charge into another combat.
And he could take on the troll.
But I won't get a charge bonus for the troll.
No, but you can stop him running through with your army.
I can take on your captain, because the fact is...
Yeah, the trolls are the key, aren't they? They're really devastating. I mean, that brute's 100 points, and I thought that was a lot for him, really.
There's also
I think it's worth it.
Troll catapults now. They have a catapult.
God, you must see a big catapult to throw a troll.
There you go. Here's a picture from the film.
Yes, there we go, look.
There's also bat swarms as well you can use.
All right. I got Warhammer figures we can use for that.
What's the bats? They move 12 inches, 25 points each, fight 3, strength 4, defence 4, 2 attacks, 2 wounds.
Sorry, can you see me yawning in the reflection there? Oh, God.
When a warbat charges, the defence of the charge model and any model that subsequently countercharges is reduced by 2.
Right.
So my guys would be defence 4, and also you can pluck them up as well.
All right, okay. Anyway, better wrap it up there. Thanks, Rob. Thanks for bringing everything round again.
No problem.
I'm really glad I made all this terrain with the boys, because I don't think we used any of it. Doesn't this look like genuine Lord of the Rings, Peter Jackson style? Hang on, imagine Legolas climbing over here.
They're taking the hardest to Isengard. Ding, 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 ding. The Uruks turn southeast.
Oh, they've just eaten their breakfast. I could tell by listening to the ground. This broken leaf. Right, that's it.